Come along now, Sextant. Yeovil, Woolworth, Theodolite, and you, Charlatella, cease your pitiful whimperings and remember to curtsy if we meet Lord Nigel.
Yes, Peter, sir.
Daddy, sir, why are the poor people so frightful? Have they not relished the moral instruction bestowed upon one by the cautionary tales told them by their nannies? Yes, Daddy, and why is their posture so terribly slovenly?
Yes, indeed. This modern world is rife with sordid aberrations, perversions, vulgarities, and ludicrous notions of equality of opportunity.
But, Daddy, I know I will never be equal to my mischievous brothers. Why must impoverishment foster such delusions of gender equanimity amongst the lower orders?
Come now, my dear Charlotella. We can never hope to comprehend the atavistic conceptions of the lowly born. It is futile and foolish of your female brain to even attempt to understand such mysteries.
Yes! Be quiet, Charlatella. Pater is unequivocally correct in his regarding of this matter.
Yes, Daddy.
Ah, Theodolite, I am indeed truly blessed to have you as my eldest son.
Yes, Daddy.
I remember well how eager your mother and I were to conceive our firstborn child. We shared the same bathwater for 6 months.
How are babies made, Father dear? One of the nasty boys at Hell House says some frightful, dirty, unthinkable things at bedtime.
Tusk, no doubt, is the son of one of those indecorous American grotesques of whom our great institutions have been so blighted of late.
Yes, Peter dear, it's that horrid boy who arrives in the vulgar for Huawei at the start of term. He needs a damn good fagging.
Yes, Daddy. Water.
Please tell us the awful things he says aren't true.
Come, come, children. Fear not, as I have already revealed to Theodolite and Sextant. A Christian child can only be sired when the Holy Ghost appears at one's bathtub and gathers flakes of exfoliated skin in his sacred crucible. These are conjoined with the mothers in the kingdom of heaven and returned to her virtuous womb to grow into an infant child.
That horrid Yankee was lying. I knew it.
And this is why we must always use our bathing tents when we swim at the seaside, children. Not only do they preserve our modesty, but also protect against unwanted pregnancies and the subsequent foundlings they create for the workhouse.
But, Daddy, I shared a bath with Cousin Nigella last summer.
Fear not, young Theodolite. Nigella has yet to be endowed with the coarse hirsutitude of procreation that will facilitate her fertility. And even were this not so, the reed smogs have been coupling with our cousins for generations. Dear children, it is a noble family tradition.
Oh, Daddy.
Yes, Charlotella.
Forgive me, but I do find these hunting trips to be most singularly tedious affairs. I know my far superior brothers enjoy larking about with guns, but I wish I was at home with Nanny Crook practicing the harpsichord. Could I please won't mind us for a while. His soft golden fur is so very comforting to my illogical feminine sensibility.
Oh, very well, Charlatella. But we will soon be needing Midas to fetch the bounty of grouse, which must languish in the barn for 40 days and 40 nights before being given to the bin men for their Christmas tip.
But Daddy...
Ah, yes, you will.
How do poor people without baths have babies?
Oh, dear young Yuville, Satan steals into their bedchamber by the light of the full moon and instructs them in his wicked dance of the two-backed beast.
Oh, Daddy, I'm scared.
They are hypnotized by Lucifer's horned helm, which brings forth unspeakable ejaculations of the most evil ecstasies.
Oh, Daddy, no!
Such diabolical offspring shall never enjoy a christening.
That's awful, Daddy.
Unlike you, young Sextant Dunstan Bridgewater, Aphonia Caducius Spaxton Reed Smog.
Oh, Daddy.
But come now, children.
Yes, sir.
You flush out those birds quivering in the heather there, young Epitaxis, with your beater. The rest of you, send them on their way to meet St. Francis in his heavenly abode. I will return presently. I have to go and attend a brief symposium with a business associate. Charlotella, hand me back Midas. You are spoiling the beast with your marmalizations.
Yes, Daddy, dear.